It's week number six, and I'm back in Brighton after 2 months of living with my mum. I thought I'd play the start of a brand new song that I've just finished. Feeling brave, gonna face this day. It's okay, it's alright. No tears will kiss my cheeks tonight. It's all good, and I'm just fine. My words ring out like hollow shells. Just slow down, it takes time. But time moves slow, I know this well. My heart breaks 1,000 times a day. But for every hope that dies, another one takes its place. Because I have the strength of a mountain. I've got the courage of the deep blue sea. I've got the heart of a lion. The stars burn bright inside of me. And although you test me, my God, I stand so proudly, can't you see? I've got the strength of a mountain. So I'll take all you throw at me. So that's my song. Today, I sort of want to talk about the things that I think that everybody should be doing, sick or not sick, to be honest. These are the things that I find help me the most, above all supplements or medicine. Before I was doing all this stuff, I felt like I had a lot less control of my symptoms. Number one, this is for everybody really, whole foods. And you might have heard of whole foods before, and what that means is just basically foods, this is a big leap, foods in the most natural form. Basically, butternut squash, this is one of my favourite bloody vegetables ever. Big onion. God, wow, that was a big onion. Look at that! Anyway, because we have evolved slower than our food has evolved, and I'll explain what I mean by that. Things like grains and so cakes, processed sugars that are going through all these manufacturing processes. It's all sort of in the past 200 years, our production of food has really evolved and progressed due to sort of technology and science. But our bodies evolve very slowly. So we've been, you know, on this planet for thousands and thousands of years, and we've adapted to the sorts of diets that we would have had before our technology came about. So we would have adapted to living off sort of like hunter-gatherer type food, which is lots of whole foods, nuts, and meat. We're getting lots of new conditions and problems that weren't illnesses that plagued people before us, simply because of the fact that we're eating so much processed stuff. So it just makes sense to sort of, for me anyway, reverting back. You can make bloody nice food with whole foods as well. Like, I've completely cut grains out of my diet, and I don't really drink milk much. I sort of make homemade yogurt every now and then. But just like eating as pure as possible is just such a beneficial thing that I think anybody can do. It's been proven to add a few years onto your life and just make your skin healthier and make you happier. And when you've got ME, it's even more important to sort of be doing things like this, because you need to give your body as much nutrients as it can get. And that's why organic is quite important as well, because even if you get vegetables that aren't organic, they're sprayed with all these pesticides and crap that actually take away some of the nutrients. And so organic is good. And even though it's a little bit pricier, it's like, if you're paying a little bit more every time to give yourself more vitality and energy, man, I think that that's definitely worth it. The second thing is yoga. Now, when I first heard about yoga, I thought it was something I thought it was something for sort of like middle-aged women to be doing. in a class, and I was right when I went to my first class because it was only me and a load of middle-aged women, some of whom were pregnant, and the instructor was saying things like, "This pose is very good for your uterus," and I don't have a uterus, so I didn't know how that was meant to feel. But ever since, I've been doing yoga, and on and off, I'm sometimes a little bit undisciplined with it, but when I do it every morning and make sure that I stick to it, man, I feel really good. Because if you do it for about a month, if you just, there's loads of videos on YouTube if you're not quite sure how to do it, that take you through different yoga poses and stuff, and they will make you feel like, if you just like try it out for maybe a month or even 2 weeks or something, and I bet you, even if you're really knackered, just going through the really gentle poses, because it doesn't really push your body that much, and you can work at your own pace. So if you feel like you need to stop, you can just stop, and you can just sort of build up. And it's a really good form of exercise because it actually gives you more energy than it takes away, I find anyway. So yoga is a really good one. It's really good for those aches and pains and stiffness, for the people with fibromyalgia as well. The third thing is, I talked about this in my other videos, is just positive thinking and trying to rewire your brain. There's a theory that ME is caused by being stuck in the fight or flight mode, which means that we're constantly giving little bursts of adrenaline, which means all our blood goes to our muscles and away from our vital organs, which is why we get things like brain fog, which is why we get things where we don't digest food properly, muscle aches, and all that sort of stuff is linked to that. So that's one theory. I think those three things, definitely, like diet, positivity, just trying to get yourself away from stress as much as possible, and yoga, are definitely things that have helped me a lot. And they're things that are open to anybody and are relatively pretty much either free or cheap to do. So I recommend, if anybody's not doing anything like that, so if you're still feeling really ill and still stuffing your face with all this sugary crap, I don't know, I think it's going to hinder the process of getting better. And I would just recommend trying eating as like whole and as from the earth as you can, because like, it's sick, bro. my little gangster coming out there. I am going to show you something new in my life. This lovely piece of piano, which my friend Grace found on Gumtree for free. So I've had that since yesterday, and it's just like, it's just so nice, and it's made me a lot happier. I'm gonna make another video to make up for the fact that I didn't do one last week, tomorrow maybe, and go about in depth as what's happened in the past 2 weeks and the new things that I'm doing. Anyway, thank you for watching.